Hello guys, welcome back. Our topics for today are variables, expressions, and statements. By the way, if you want to open Jupyter Notebook as I have done here, you can just search for Jupyter Notebook in your search bar and then you hit enter. This will open for you. So Jupyter Notebook has opened for us. Then you go to new and you select Python 3 IP kernel. To open for you and then you can follow along everything that I'll be doing, or you can also search for Anaconda Navigator and then when it's open you hit enter. When it opens for you, Navigator opens for you, just click on launch here and then the Jupyter Notebook will be open for you. Also, if you already have your favorite editor that you normally use or IDE that you normally use, you can follow along with any code editor or IDE. So we have here that a variable is a named location in the memory that is reserved to store a value. Now, many a time you'll be wanting to save some data and then we use it anywhere in our code. Like we want to know the number of students in a class, and then anywhere that we want to use the number of students in a class in our code, we will just call something and then we can use that number of students together with some data and calculate for some results. So that is the importance of variables. We can achieve it by assigning that number of students to a variable. So let's say if I want to assign the value 1 to the variable A, this is how we achieve it in Python. Then we are good to go. So we have here A, then I am assigning 1 to it. So here in mathematics, we know that in our basic math, we know that this equal operator is an equal sign mathematics. But actually in Python, we say it's an assignment operator. So we have to know that. And then the double equal sign is an equal sign in Python. So we will be dealing with this a lot. And also we are saying that expression is a piece of code that evaluates to a value. So what we have here, the one on our right hand side is a value and then it's also an expression. And we can also name another variable, let's say b, and then we assign to, let me say, plus the variable a. So this one is also, the right hand side is also an expression, and then the left hand side is the name of the variable. All right, that is what we meant by expression is a piece of code that evaluates to a value. We have your statement is a single or an entire line of code that performs a specific action or operation. This means that whatever that we have here is a statement. Up there too is a statement. Each line of code is a statement in Python. That is what we meant by that. So you will take this now, and next lesson you will look at the rules governing naming a variable. We have some rules that we must follow before we can name a variable properly. We can't just use anything to name a variable. So we look at the rules governing naming a variable in the next video. There are a lot of things that we are going to learn about variables, but we'll be looking at them as we code along. So let's take this for now, and then we look at the rules for naming variables in the next lesson. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.